Hello. I don't know about you, but whenever I see these news with billionaires colonizing Mars or hunting unicorns, I end up thinking about Cyclopean Walls. The link is clear, but I'll explain it anyway. We know there are quite a few mysteries regarding Cyclopean Walls, like when they were built, by whom, for what, and even how did they do it. However, there is one issue that does not seem to raise many doubts. That is the titanic amount of work and skill needed to build these magnificent walls. And for more reasons than it meets the eye. For one, there were no metal tools used. The walls are reaching us from a time before iron, the so-called Bronze Age in Europe. Also in Peru, where the Incas did not have metal. Or even in Japan, where iron was too scarce. Without iron, the stones had to be slowly polished into shape. But there's more. There is no way to have an assembly line of cyclopes. Whilst the boring squared blocks are mass-produced, with teams working in parallel, specialized in measuring, shopping, transporting, assembling, etc. Cyclopean walls are arty-crafty, since only after one stone is fully finished into place is when the builders can go on to work on the next one. One of my hobbies, I know, it's weird, is looking at polygonal walls and sorting out the order in which they were built. Most sites are too eroded to be easy to guess, but in Cusco, Peru, it's clear to see how each stone had another one placed beforehand. One can even do a number chart. With all that work, we would expect the walls to be built scarcely, only when grave circumstances demanded, like in a major threat or emergency. However, the evidence we got is quite the opposite. Sometimes, all that is left from a major ancient city are the polygonal walls, with all the other constructions just gone. There is an immediate reason for that. Polygonal masonry is sturdy, earthquake and water resistant. Thus, after some time, whatever else was built around it got erased, whilst the cyclopean stones still stand tall. Another reason for the walls not to be subject to destruction is because they are hardly ever used for defense. Sometimes we have not a clue on what they were up for. But it's clearly not military. Take this example, in Cosa. Look at how the vigilance towers are not cyclopean. They were added later on. The original builders had no eye for surveillance. This was not a castle back then. Or in Segni, where the wall just goes downhill, giving up the higher ground advantage to an invading army. And also, they have no gates, as seen in Norba. Whilst Orbetello is just a land yacht, an island. I guess it's clear from all those examples that the monocular builders were not setting up military units. Sure, the walls did provide some degree of safety, but not against an invading army. Was it because the builders were narrow-sighted or had the Cyclopes another target in view? Remember that building Cyclopean walls is very time-consuming. So, setting them up in case of an upcoming war was not a good idea. Before all that refined puzzle was even halfway through, any invading army had time to come in and crush the party. So, if it required painstaking work and they were not built for the military, i.e. they were what we would call today private buildings, what they were aiming for? My answer is in two words: privacy and show-off, both at the same time. Let's see. All that work, 3D puzzling stones, was surely expensive. Only super rich people could afford it. Furthermore, the wall's best usage was to build high-end terrain, elevated plains, acropolis, where the important people could stand separated from the populace down, but at the same time dropping an eye on them. In the last video, I mentioned how the Romans believed the walls were built for Saturn, the inventor of clocks and agriculture. Hope you get to see that one. This uneasy mix of both privacy and show-off is still very fashionable today with the uber-rich. We can see it in the open with the craze for ever bigger super-yachts. These gloriously expensive boats, costlier than the Navy frigate, are used both to prevent contact with us, the populace, while still showing off how rich the owners are. Even better than a super yacht, Cyclopean walls are the ultimate bling. Perfect for a living god, the type of guy that just invented agriculture or the internet and is now enjoying himself high up there. Separated from us, but still making sure we get to see he's doing just fine. With the extra advantage that boats sink rapidly, and Cyclopean walls are a legacy for the millennia. And for that much, I'm ready to bet that Elon won't be such a grand name in the future, at least not as much as Saturn is today. With this, we finish the videos about Cyclopean walls in Italy. I hope you get to see them whilst I go around and think up of what's next. Or you can leave me a suggestion in the comments. Hope you like it. I'll be back.